Master Raven. Li Chao Lan.
もっとエレガントなものだ。
Apártate de mi vista.
Sigue así.
y te acabarán matando.
私を倒せるとでも思っておるのか？貴様から、全てを取り戻す！戦いと最後にどちらが立っているか、それだけだ。覚悟はできたか？では見せてもらおう。その力どれほどのものか。食らうがい
エリー・ゴールド、
受けますよ。
Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the Tech and Talk for March 2017. We're joined by some fantastic guests. Of course, you know this guy to my left, the one and only Mark Mann, Mark Julio, in the house. And we got Bronson as well as Andy to pros of Tekken.
We are not pros.
At some point in the Tekken timeline, they were pros.
This guy owns a joystick company, and I just get sticks from him. That's what
okay. That's the relationship
that's
you guys
our relationship.
Have.
Okay. Where but, are they now?
But again, you guys know Dalton. Dalton is helping with a lot of the stuff here over at Bandai Namco Entertainment, also known as Devil Ginger.
Gingerine.
All right. But you guys probably remember him from the Collision stream. But again, thank you guys for tuning in. It's been a long time since we've had a Tekken Talk session, so I'm glad that we're able to bring it back, and hopefully we'll be able to do this on a more regular basis. But I'm sure with Gingerine on the squad, it'll be a lot easier for us to pull this off.
Yeah. But yeah, if you guys don't know, I'm the new community manager for Bandai Namco, so I cover all things Bandai Namco, Tekken, Dark Souls, you name it. But, you know, it's all about Tekken today, so we're here to show you some awesome stuff. We got some characters that we're going to show some gameplay from. Eddie. We got the pandas, Panda and Kuma, ready to show you. We got some great new merchandise. We got the collectors right here. You can see the we actually have the statue from the collector's edition in the flesh that we can show you. We got some of the pop game Funko toys in the house as well. And we're also doing an awesome giveaway. So keep an eye out in the chat. I'll be posting in the chat the link for the giveaway. So. Andy was lucky enough, happy enough to give us a Quamba Obsidian stick to give away, which is awesome. So keep an eye on that link. You just need to follow our page, our Twitch page or our Tekken pages on Facebook to increase your number of entries for the giveaway. We also have five Crying Heihachi hats to give away as well.
So six winners overall. So make sure you guys enter the contest.
Again, I think everyone knows that hat. The hat's.
Oh yeah,
you know,
this is the good hat. Yeah. This isn't the hat, the other hat that. If, you
can,
know.
Can I enter these?
You can if you have your mobile device, but your phone's over there. Just chill.
This is rigged.
It is rigged. But again, if you guys have a chance, again, look for the links in the stream chat. But they're also on the Tekken Twitter page as well. So make sure you guys enter. We will be picking the winners right at the end of the show.
Yeah.
And we'll be contacting them directly. But either way, let's get started with the show. Hell, there's a lot of cool stuff happening. Hot off of the recent Tekken event over in Atlanta, Georgia. Final round 20. 20 long years now, final round event. Doesn't that make you feel old?
A little.
But for 20 long years, everyone knows Atlanta is a hotbed for Tekken community. And it was really nice for us to have such a great international event there. Players from all over the world, especially Korea, Japan, and a lot of players from around the United States representing and having fun and playing some Tekken. And in case you guys missed it, there was a very exciting top eight going into the event. We were at Collision, Dalton and I, in Peru.
Yeah.
And we saw the decimation, the two new Echo Fox boys from Korea, JDCR and Saint.
I think everyone in the Tekken community knows those guys.
Oh, yeah. They were able to easily handle the competition over there. But the King of Iron Fist Tournament 2016 champion, Saint, also the EVO champion from last year, did not make it into top eight at final round for some reason. Maybe he fell to the ATL hype. Maybe he had a bad haircut. Who knows? But one of the guys expected to place into or get into the grand finals at the very least wasn't there. JDCR even had a shaky road leading up into the top eight, losing to Joey Fury in the winner's bracket. So, I mean, I got to ask you guys, what do you guys feel about the good old red, white, and blue, the American Tekken squad?
Really proud to see them do so well at final round. Yeah, Joey Fury's defense was on point, and he had JDCR's Heihachi pretty well, too.
Oh, yeah. And that was going into it, Anakin even mentioned. Anakin, one of the top players that we saw last year during the Tekken Tour, he mentioned himself that there's no Jack that's going to beat JDCR. And he had to eat his words right there.
Yeah.
It happened.
I think this is a much more simpler game for people to get into.
Oh, yeah.
So the
not necessarily a bad thing, though.
No, it's great, right? It's
more accessible.
You get these crappy Americans beating Koreans.
Oh, no.
We're slowly killing that gap between skill within the game.
Yeah.
Right? So when you're a mid-tier to top-tier American player.
Like? You really want to name names?
Who knows? There were a lot of upsets that probably shouldn't have happened, obviously. And then you get into a simple game where there's high damage and one life bar with a built-in comeback mechanic.
You know, it's been a while because the community, especially around the world, everyone's been playing Tag 2 for the past few years. So Tekken 7, obviously the new flavor.
And they always complain about damage in Tekken Tag 2. And I will forever defend that game, right? And now you play this game, which I dabble a little bit in. And I see 50% combos. I see 40% supers. There are things in this game that make it a lot easier to come back in a 1v1 situation.
Yeah. You know, the mechanics like the Rage Art, Rage Drive. Yeah. There's a lot of things in there that can really turn the tides of battle, you know, which is awesome because it...
Is it really awesome?
I think it's awesome.
It's awesome as long as you're not getting hit by it, right?
From a spectator point of view, I think this is probably one of the best games for a casual player to come watch. I think this will really get a lot of hype, right? Because you have those supers, you have the flashiness, and you also have these slow-mos.
Oh, I love the slow-mos.
Insane,
everyone loves the slow-mos,
right?
Man.
So, yeah, from that view. But then from a player perspective, it's a simple game to get into. Maybe it'll be hard to master. Who knows? The game's not even out yet, right? So, there's, you know, what I see from America, it should really have them go... Not really going, I'm good enough now. It's like, no, dude, the game is easier. You should spend more time learning it,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
So it's all about refinement. You know, we asked JDCR after the tournament, what does he think? And he openly said, like, it's not going to take that long for American players or the rest of the world to really catch up with where Korea and where Japan are, who's been playing for 2 to 3 years now on the arcade version. So it's going to be interesting when the game comes out June 2nd. And it's not just on PS4, it's not just on Xbox One, it's also going to be on Steam for the first time.
4K native.
And it's going to be fun. I think it's going to be really interesting to see, especially with such a big event around the corner. There's going to be Evo in mid-July, just a month and a half after the game comes out. So that period, that's going to be the grind where people are going to try to play their best and learn as much as they can about the game.
And you know, there's characters in the console version that were never in Fate of Retribution. So when people get the game on June 2nd, who knows what character they're going to start learning. There's going to be new matchups. There's going to be balance tweaks. The meta is going to change. And I think that's kind of what the Korean guys are talking about. There's a lot of shifts in the game that are coming up that are going to start to really level out that playing field.
If you add like 2-4 characters from now until then, it's not going to change that much.
Are you guys adding more characters?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, let's not talk about that.
Wait, Bret Hart's in the game?
Who? We'll talk about that later. We'll talk about guest characters later.
Yeah, there are some guest characters that we're going to talk about later, but, you know. Let's focus on the game that's coming out June 2nd first before we get.
Either
on
way,
that.
It was exciting top eight.
Top eight, final round, obviously one of the best Tekken events to go to.
Yeah.
I was really happy to be there. I was able to do the top eight with Tasty Steve. Lots of love over to everyone over the final round team, Larry, Shin Blanca.
Was that the one you commentated for like 20 hours in a row?
I've done that many times in my life.
That's a standard for this
was,
guy.
It was one of them. It was one of them. But it, I mean, it
You're
was
You're about
fun.
To do that NCR too, bro.
okay.
Hey, well, no.
Speaking
perfect
of NCR.
Perfect segue. Wow, nice work.
Well, there's a lot of events coming up for the community. Before we go into all the nitty-gritty gameplay stuff later on and talk about all the cool stuff, let's talk about some events. So there are a few events coming up leading up to the console release. Next month, April, is going to be an action-packed month for Tekken fans. So if you are in the United States and you have access to go to these events, I want everyone to come out there. So April 7th through 9th, to start off, we have Northwest Majors, and that's going to be happening in the Seattle area. So if you guys have a chance, Pacific Northwest players have been super dedicated to the game. They've been throwing a lot of great events for Tekken Tag Tournament 2.
I agree.
Really amped up for Tekken 7. I'm excited to see all the competition that shows up to that event. That exact same weekend, there's also an event in the Midwest in St. Louis, Wizard World's event. They're having another Tekken 7 event, but they're going to be playing the arcade version. So we'll be...
So
but
for
just so you
Northwest
know.
Northwest Majors and NCR, we're going to be playing the PS4 build.
Okay.
Nice.
Wizard
and
World.
Which build is that?
It's the good one.
Yeah.
No information.
No information. But once we have the information, we'll let everyone know. Just, of course, follow Tekken on Twitter.
Yeah.
We'll have all the info.
That build doesn't have the full roster, but it has almost the full roster. So it's
He's
got
like, what does that mean?
Oh, it's got Miguel. You know, it's got...
Let's keep the suspense going, right? Okay. We'll figure out what building.
The game will be there.
The game will be there. Everyone should show up.
Yeah, and you know...
This is my first time going to NCR in, like, years.
Oh, yeah. So, speaking of which, right after that week, the doubleheader, we have St. Louis and we have Seattle. The following week, we have NorCal Regionals in Sacramento, and this is going to be the first time that Tekken's been at NCR in quite some time.
Yeah.
So, years. I believe you're joining the tournament.
I was tricked into it by Choi.
Nice.
Our
so
great
John
Choi.
Thank you for tricking the great insanely Johnson Tran.
You know, we're based here in Santa Clara, and you know, Sacramento's not too far, and we want
to. It is. 2 hours?
See, all right, that's so how far I drive to work.
You're getting paid to go out there. There's a difference.
But,
I'm paying money to go there.
But regardless, you know, there's a lot of great players, including yourselves, in this area, and we want to make sure that, you know, we show up
and
support.
It's all about exposure, right? And it's a great thing to do as we are priming up for the release date.
Yeah, so if you guys are interested in any of those events, you can check it out. We'll tweet the events and the websites. That way you can sign up and register. If you just want to check out and spectate the event, of course, you'll have a chance to play some Tekken. There will be some free play going on throughout the weekend. But I'm really excited. I'm glad we're going to see Tekken in NorCal again.
Definitely.
And I hope a lot of the local crowd shows up. I think it'll be fun.
We'll see. I mean, we have a lot of strong Tekken players here, and we'll see who actually enters.
Nice.
But I know there's going to be casuals. There's going to be a lot of casuals there, probably.
And that pretty much rounds it up for April. Those are the three events, which is, I think, a lot for a single month.
Yeah.
But in May, we're going to be focusing on a Combo Breaker that's going to be taking place in the Chicago area.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm super excited about that. Last year, we had an amazing event at Combo Breaker, and I hope everyone's really looking forward to that. Last year was, I believe, the start of Anakin's Reign of Terror when he started entering tournament after tournament, giving up his spot. And I hope we have a good turnout this year. That's happening at the end of May, just a week before the game comes out on console and on PC.
I've heard nothing but good things about Combo Breaker.
Oh, yeah. Rick, the Hado, and his team, they throw an amazing event. I'm really looking forward to going to Combo Breaker this year. I heard the hotel's already sold out. So if you're going there, good luck trying to find accommodations. Yeah. But there are other options. But do some research.
Anyway, as we're leading up the launch, we have a lot of great tournaments in place. But, you know, everyone stay tuned. We're going to have a lot of great news for more, even more tournaments. The scene's going to get even bigger once we hit that June 2nd launch date. Everyone gets their hands on the console version. I think that's really going to expand.
For free? Dalton?
I'm not an MCOP. Remember that. I'm not an MCOP, guys.
I see a lot of eyes around us, guys.
Yeah.
No, I mean, we're not giving away the game for free. But, you know, there's definitely the game's coming out. And once it's in the hands of all the players, there's going to be a lot of new players coming up. There's going to be a lot more information coming in the tournament scene coming up. So just stay tuned for that as well.
And then the pre-order deal. There's a pre-order deal, right? That sounds pretty groovy.
You are a better salesman than
right? So I'm just a poor, poor Asian boy living
Are you trying
San
to turn
Jose,
this
California.
Turn this around?
I'm just saying, that's pre-order deal. Unlike other games where there's season passes and all that stuff, we're actually getting characters once you pre-order.
Correct.
So
you guys see that beautiful character there on the bottom left of your screen? That's Eliza.
Eliza. Yeah,
okay.
And she is included for everyone that purchases the game at launch or within the launch window. Eliza will be available.
Yeah, she's
for
a
you
pre-order
well.
Bonus character. So if you pre-order on any console or any console PC or any SKU, you will get Eliza day one as a character. So great incentive to pre-order, and she's an awesome character. She adds a lot to the roster. So
is she recommend good? It.
They're all good. This is Tekken. Anyone can be good.
Hey, man, he's the cop. He has the gun, all right? We got to be careful.
But anyways. Wrong people holding the gun, man.
Yeah. Hey, better him than you. Yeah.
What do you mean? At least I know there's bad characters in the game.
Okay. There are no bad characters.
There's no bad characters.
Just bad players.
There's only bad players.
That's
listen,
right.
I've been
this guy was
this
getting beat earlier, and he was
for 16 years, 17 years. All right.
What was the last time you played in a tournament? Was it Evo? Who'd you lose to?
Me.
He did lose.
I lost again. I lost again. He's pretty good.
That's right.
Yeah.
You lost again, and Jody the Great. Right. Jody the
Can
Great. You guys probably.
What do we have next in the agenda?
Oh, let's
here?
Look. Okay, but there's a reason why we call him Jody the Great. It's because he beat Bronson that one
year. That's what happens though. People once they beat me, they hold on to it. You know, because that's like their only.
In his head, they do.
Well, I mean,
in his head, they do.
Even when I'm a has-been, and they beat me, that's their crown achievement in their career.
We need to clear this up. You were never going to be a has-been. You were the only person that has ever been a double national champion.
Yeah, that was like 13 years ago.
Tekken 4 is Tekken 5.
A long time ago. So after a while, you get worse, and then real life comes up, and then you want to put in more time, but your skills are not there.
Okay, well, so now that real life has, I mean, you have a job now.
Yeah, dude.
You have some kind of income.
It took me 30 years to get a job.
But because of that, you're able to afford things like the collector's edition of the game.
Exactly. I'm like pre-ordering like crazy, even though I got my homeboy over here looking at me with the pre-order sheets. Going, don't worry, Bronson. Don't worry,
you.
Mark R.
Let's talk a little bit
about
the game.
That.
So we mentioned already, if you pre-order the title, get it around launch, you'll get Eliza included.
Yes.
But there are a number of options out there. And, of course, it's going to vary depending on the region you're at. So for all the information, check out Tekken.com for the info on pre-ordering the game. But let's talk about the collector's edition, which will be available in most areas right now.
Awesome.
So what is this contraption here? What do we have here? Oh, man, let me try to pick this up. This thing looks heavy.
Get it up to the camera. Show the detail.
Okay. All right, so I got it. Oh crap!
They actually
that's quality.
Sent
don't
the
drop it.
They sent the manufacturer the actual models from the game.
Yeah.
So these are all to scale. The texture work, the quality of the statue is awesome.
Nice.
So it's the epic showdown between Kazuya and Heihachi there.
He's
at the volcano.
He's been doing yoga or something. He's really limber. But yeah, this is obviously part of the collector's edition. And wow, look at the detail on Heihachi.
Yeah, the detail on the textures of the gi.
What is that? Can I take that off and wear it myself? But it's again only in the collector's edition, which it's sold out on most websites, but I believe it's still available on your website on the Bandai Namco.
Yeah, I'm gonna drop a link in right now into the chat
to
the Bandai Namco for the collector's edition.
And also, I think still the PS4 version is available on Best Buy, I believe.
Yeah, Best Buy still got some. I'm pretty sure Amazon sold out.
And
but
GameStop
they're,
is sold out.
Yeah, they're going fast. So if you're a huge fan and you want to add this to your collection, it's a great thing to put on your shelf, you know, put up on your mantle. It's an awesome kind of depiction of that epic showdown between father and son. It's awesome. So
I'm looking forward to it. One of these guys are going to die, so I'm not going to.
No spoilers.
But I hope it's that one. You like how I just pointed?
No, you pointed towards Kazuya, dude. I saw you.
No, I didn't. I like
you
Kazuya.
Did.
Kazuya point? Collects sneakers. I'm down with that guy.
Yeah, I know. Isn't that one of his likes in Tekken 4?
Tekken 1.
Tekken 1.
Yeah.
Cool. So moving on, another awesome thing that we want to show off is the exclusive Jin. So if you pre-order Tekken 7 on any platform, we're just announcing that today. So Steam, Xbox One, or PS4, you can get the limited edition Jin for only $5 on the store. So if you pre-order on the Bandai Namco store, the Tekken 7, you get this figure for just $5. So
and
it's awesome.
This is the exclusive version. This is actually different what you'll find at other retailers. So if you can hand me the other Jin one there. So there's Tekken 3 Jin, and then this is Tekken 4, or I guess Tekken 5 Jin.
Yeah, so he's got the two colored pants, the gloves with the gloves with different. The different different
there you
logo.
Go. That's the image. Yeah, don't look at us.
Yeah, dude, just look at me right look. Here, dude. Why you take the camera off me, Mark?
That's cool. It's I think the shine. Kids have had enough. But yeah, it's exclusive, obviously, to the Bandai Namco Entertainment store. So make sure
I'm
you guys
throwing
check out
throwing the link in nice. The chat as well for the exclusive figurine. If you want to buy that separately, you can. And then obviously, if you bundle it with the game, you get it for only $5. So. It's a pretty awesome deal.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So make sure you so when you pre-order your four different copies later, make sure you do it.
Bronson's going to buy 10 copies.
Besides that, the game plus Eliza.
Yeah,
Eliza?
Okay, so it varies per region. So for North America, the collector's edition will come with this statue and the game.
Okay.
And and the soundtrack and...
And the Eliza DLC.
So soundtrack. Eliza, does the soundtrack come with a pre-order?
No. Only in the collector's edition. So there's a number of differences depending on the
I'm
region
learning
you're
so
at.
Much now.
Yes, there's a lot to learn. And speaking of which, I don't know if you guys can get a good shot of this, but we'll show it on the main screen as well. This is the Heihachi Fig Pin. So if you have ordered the game or pre-ordered the game at GameStop, you have an opportunity to get this really cool Heihachi Pin. I think it's awesome. If you're a Power Up Rewards member and you pre-order through GameStop, you will be getting this for free. When you pick up your game.
Yeah. On June 2nd, when you go to pick up your game at GameStop, you get this pin. So it's awesome. And it's a good exclusive. So.
And there's also other characters as well within the Fig Pin line for Tekken 7. And they'll be available at various retailers. So make sure you guys look up information on that. We'll be posting about it.
Yeah.
You like my infomercial spiel?
Yeah. I love
Are
that.
You laughing?
Is a Fig Pin a figurine pin? What is that?
That's the company.
Dude,
that's just the company.
Yeah, but that's what they're going for, like a bigger pin.
You are smarter than I am because I didn't even think about that.
So one thing I want to call out that we didn't talk about is you also get a steel book with the collection edition.
Oh, word?
Yeah.
Steel book, huh?
What's that?
It's so when you steel throw it, it doesn't break.
Yeah, steel book is the collectible case.
It's not
it's
really
a locking system.
It's still plastic.
I don't know.
Bronson's like that guy
right?
on the QVC that just asked the questions about the product. He's like, "What
I'm
does that
to
do?"
Set you guys up for success, right? Right. Someone needs to. Yeah. If I'm asking it, someone's asking.
Yeah. Awesome. Okay. So yeah.
So other than that, there's the Funkos that you guys saw. There's a ton of them. Actually, a lot of them are out and available in stores now.
Yeah. We got Nina. We got Heihachi. We got Young Heihachi. We got Kazuya, Devil Jin. We got King. So that, you know you. If one of your favorite characters, you'll be able to find the one that fits your play style.
Yeah, I guess. But that's cool. So a lot of Tekken merchandise. I believe there's a lot more cool stuff down the way. There's you guys can see that big box in the background there. So,
yeah.
There is a special arcade stick that's going to be available from GameStop and Amazon when the game comes out. You guys are looking at the. Let me bring it up on screen. There might be a little bit of a glare, but from Hori we have this. Awesome Tekken 7 arcade stick that features the Noir layout, which is the same layout that you find in the Japanese arcades. So really cool stuff. Features key artwork from both Heihachi and Kazuya.
Yeah.
Of course, the faded battle between father and son. You know,
and
we're getting to that age now. I don't know if you guys are planning kids or anything.
I have a dog.
Okay. Do you plan on throwing your dog down a cliff? Or into
sometimes,
a volcano.
Sometimes.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I missed the window. My daughter's old now, so I can't do it anymore.
She might fight back.
Yeah,
she'll
fight
throw
back.
You off. Yeah,
exactly.
She's a grown woman now.
Yeah, and we had these at PAX East, and they're fantastic. So a lot of fans got out of their hands on the stick. A lot of great feedback. Really well constructed. It's got a nice weight to it. Really good button feel. Good, just overall great stick. So
yeah. So lots of love to our friends over at Hori. This will be available for PS4 and Xbox One. So if you guys want more information, make sure you guys look it up through either GameStop or Amazon, and it will be available when the game comes out.
Yeah. Awesome. So what do you think? Should we move on to some gameplay?
I think a lot of people want to see the gameplay. So for the first time, we're going to be showing you guys gameplay of the Panda, Kuma, some of the new stages, and of course Eddie Gordo.
And
in the
I've heard that Mark is a pro with every single of those characters.
Yeah. Because as we said earlier, there's no bad characters, only bad players. So
I've been a bad player for a good 17 years of my life.
So cool.
Oh, yeah, this is the controller I'm using. Yeah, so we'll go right into the game. So we're doing this one. Give us a second while
we
commentate on
these. Oh,
you guys are going to do commentary?
Professional players.
Yeah, Feel free to ask questions. I mean, let's not go too in-depth. Let's just give them something exciting to watch. So,
well, that's really up to you guys to give them something exciting.
So we're playing on the PS4 Pro here, which is awesome.
I don't even have a PS4 Pro yet or a 4K TV. I need to upgrade my lifestyle. Maybe I should become a NAMM cop, huh?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna use my boy. I'm gonna use Eddie.
Sold a couple of shoes, a couple of sticks. You can get
I think anything. We need to. No, let's never. Do a new matchup. I'm gonna go Kuma.
Oh, whoa! Look at that outfit.
That's so tight.
Yeah. Okay, right. So while we're getting ready to load, so let's show off some of the new stages. So as you guys know the Mashima Dojo, Forgotten Realm from the arcade version, but let's go to some of the new stages here that we want to show off.
There's a lot of stages.
That,
you guys.
But we have the.
It's new to me, damn it.
Oh, Arena. Arena's brand new.
Oh, let's do that one. That's the esports stage. Let's do that.
Yeah. We're not esports, bro.
You guys remember, like, if you played any of the old Tekkens, the word arena was either a nightmare or.
This is the only stage we play on.
Yes.
Nothing else.
The most broken. One of the most broken stages in the game.
Is this canon storyline? Like, where did Eddie come from? How do you come back?
You'll find out once you play the game.
You need to wait until June 2nd to play the whole story mode. You'll learn all the characters.
I don't play story mode.
No, you are playing story mode.
It took me 2 years to find out there was two Armor Kings.
Okay, you were so lucky Tasty's not on the show. He would have like told you the entire lore.
Yeah, but he's an idiot, so I don't believe him.
we're talking over it, and we missed the intro where Kuma throws a fish at the screen, which is the greatest thing of all time.
All right, we're going to get into it. So
who's who? Mark is Eddie?
Yes, that's me.
All right.
Oh.
It's such a pretty game, honestly.
Yeah.
Nice combo, bro.
I'm still playing Tag 2 in my head.
Let's go.
See? Tag 2. Okay. Oh, damn it.
Did you guys notice that, though? It didn't look like it comboed when everything hit.
It doesn't anymore.
Yes.
But, still a work in progress.
Oh, new.
Bicep 2?
They brought it back.
Nice combo.
Did he?
Not enough. Right on the
bad
bad
you
calculation
are representing
there.
Namco right now, right? You have to beat him.
He's not going to do it.
Look at the floor.
Yeah, the floor, as you can see, the floor lights up based on where they're standing, which is awesome.
Oh, they only care about you winning, Dalton. Concentrate. Get off the wall.
I'm trying, man. I'm trying.
I'm just like coaching him over. Yeah, press the hella button.
Oh, did he hit me again?
Yeah. Nice. All right, here we go. The fish.
Playing Geeter?
It's the fish slam. The greatest raid
card
in the
game.
No
damage.
Are you complaining?
Yeah.
You know who to email.
Listen, Harada and I have not been on speaking terms for a while. He's not going to listen to whatever he does.
He can't understand your English anyway.
he's not going to listen to me at all. But that did no damage. How come that super did nothing?
I'm surprised. The Miguel one does the one.
I mean, he's a bear. You think he'd do more, right?
Right.
Yeah, that can't be right. But whatever. It's a work in progress.
Yeah, this isn't the final build, so. But the first time.
He's got all those clothes on.
That battle gear.
It's because he has that gear. It's plus 10 to defense, but it's -1 to
what
offense.
What kind of ads we got in the background here?
I don't know. We should look at that.
It's like lightning bubblegum.
Wild hog.
Yeah, these are the important things.
Oh, again? It's like 2 for 2 now.
Let's see how much damage it does this time.
It hits that, and then.
Yeah. Oh, it's decent damage.
Dude, but look how little life he has. Last time he had less life.
Dude, let's not talk about his lifestyle here. Oh, he's in the game.
That was good.
Mark.
Sorry. let's get another. Let's pick different characters.
Yeah.
Let's get a new stage too.
Yeah, we're gonna go.
I love this menu, by the way, where you can go either to character select or to stage
super
select.
Quick
and the thing is, it's great because the loser gets to pick that option.
Yeah.
It's not. Just
we don't
the
have
first
this,
player.
Right?
No thumbs up here. let's not get into it. Speaking of which, I think I'll try Akuma.
Akuma? I'll go Panda.
Yeah, I'm glad you're showing everyone, you know, the character.
Yeah.
No, actually, I'm going to use Eddie again.
Yeah, I mean, let's show Eddie.
Let's show the new stuff. This is
the first time we've really showed Eddie.
You have to hit him so he gets rage, so he can do the super.
Let's show some of the other new stage. You got
whoa, what is that?
Geometric planes.
Go with that.
It's like the practice.
Not only will Tekken teach you to be a better player, they also gives you a geometry lesson. All right, got it. But this is new stuff. I mean,
this is, other than the trailers, this is the first time that Panda has been shown in real gameplay, as well as Kuma and Eddie. So
is Panda finally faster and Kuma stronger now, or are they?
I haven't played Panda yet. I've only used Kuma, so I can't say for sure. But I would assume they're the same.
This stage is crazy.
It's got awesome reflection.
He didn't complete the counter.
I thought you guys were doing commentary.
Nah, dude, I'm so mesmerized by this
stage.
I mean, the stage that when the tiles
break.
You
got like Tetris going on
in the
background.
I can't multitask very well. So if I'm seeing these weird ass colors. Also, this gameplay is not very motivating to commentate.
That's cool.
That's not the same as I play too, so don't worry about it. Damn, Mark is just playing Tekken 5 VR right now.
I'll start doing some VR combos too.
You do that.
Try some new moves.
Okay, let's show the cool stuff.
Oh, nice.
Wait, so that's the new power crush, right?
That's the power crush. Okay. And I believe it's his power. He's only from stance.
Yeah. Is that also his rage drive is also from stance, or is it standing?
No, his rage drive, if Dalton can actually hit me, we'll show you guys.
Or rage armor.
Oh, there. Okay, so that's still not going to get me into rage, but we'll see what we can do.
Oh, yeah. Pandas.
Volleyball.
Volleyball.
So cute, dude.
That was so
more
cool.
More damage, by the way.
Yeah, it looked like a different
dude, Kuma is low tier. Kuma is low tier. His damage is not as
high. Oh, here we go. Eddie's.
Any clothes,
Eddie's hits. All right. Here's Eddie's rage art.
Look at this pose, man.
The power pose.
B-boy freeze.
Let's finish this.
Eddie's boom!
Good finish. Good finish.
Round three. Dude. Fight. I don't like. This game's amazing.
Why are you? I'm like, what are you trying to say, bro?
This game's amazing. I'm not being censored or anything. This game is actually pretty fun to play, though. I must admit. Watching vanilla and watching the progression of how it's changed and adapted to what it is now, way better than what I saw before.
Even the graphics, too, like the filter they added on the stage is a lot sharper and cleaner.
Oh my goodness, that's gonna hurt.
Oh yeah. Oh. Volleyball. Magic volleyball.
Does it walk in?
Spike.
We'll see.
You know, I'm just setting this up because I want to do the rage eye, right?
Dude.
Okay, let's do it. Let's do
mercy rounds over here.
Oh,
he wasn't ready. He wasn't ready.
You know what's funny is that one. I always think it's just the one hit, and then he spins around and does
that's
that second
hit.
Yeah,
it's
beauty,
like surprise.
Yeah,
you fell for my trap card.
Second hit is such a surprise. All right, let's keep a few more rounds going here. Show off some new stages.
Yeah, let's do one more right before we get to the next.
The stages are really pretty.
Stages are great.
You just saw two of them.
Let's show Azure.
So, dude, that one's so pretty.
So just from a dumb question, because I'm
just from a dumb question.
I'm not very smart.
Uh-huh. Okay. We know
the
that.
PS Pro, yeah, obviously. So PS Pro, like, not everyone has a PS Pro, right? So if I'm playing on my little itty bitty normal ghetto PlayStation 4, how are the graphics gonna look from there?
I don't think there's gonna be a huge difference. I mean, there's no details really out yet on the differences.
I think the biggest change will be is if you play on PC. You know, if you wanna up to PC, that's.
So are you part of the PC Overload gang and all that?
He's one of those. He was talking to me about
PC
video cards all day.
I mean, I love PC gaming, but when it comes to fighting games, I usually play console, just because that's just where everyone's playing, and
that's cool.
It's kind of where the competitive scene is. So.
All right. So
and then on the PC side,
Kuma and
on the
Kuma
PC
versus
side,
Kuma.
Dude,
just add the
I
A.
I can use the dragon on the PC side, right?
Yeah, it works on PC too.
Yeah.
And Obsidian too.
Native X input. For the Columbus.
All right,
so what stage?
Stages,
where are we going?
Stages. Let's go to
something beautiful.
Yeah, we're gonna go to something.
Azure?
Yeah,
water stage.
Dude, there's a lot of new stages.
Yeah,
wow.
There's two.
Or the Kinder Gym. Should we go to the Panda stage?
Let's do that Azure. We haven't done that
Infinite
one.
Infinite Azure.
Yeah.
All right, I'm excited to showcase this one.
When I see that word, I just think of a free-to-play card game.
Azure?
Dragon Drake.
All right. Are you one of those guys?
Oh, God.
Pay to win?
Spell damage.
It's not going to work in Tekken, bro.
Spell damage, draw card. Spell damage, draw card.
There's no pay to win on Tekken.
So this
man.
Is the match a lot of people wanted to see.
Oh, yeah,
Akuma
here we go.
Versus Akuma.
Look at this Kuma. The Kuma a trout Kuma throw is Akuma. Maybe my favorite intro in the game.
It reminds me of Brian's. And child's fulfillment. Yeah. That is some deep word, man.
So here, this stage is awesome. Obviously, it doesn't have any walls, but just...
I feel like Kuma belongs here. Like he just
this is the
searching for sound.
This is where he hunts salmon, man. Oh, nice.
This is not doing anything.
Definitely not.
Oh, counter hit 4.
Oh,
missed the juggle though, and then get the Wasang 2 to the back. And then the bear goes wild.
Oh.
Never mind. That was a horrible. Can you have killed him? You had EX.
I wanted to
save meter for next.
Dude, I'm trying to do the full.
That's too smart. That's
full.
Too smart for me. You could have died though.
You're right.
Just go for the
just
win.
Burn the meter, bro.
Oh,
finish off
nice.
The round.
Oh man, low
the bear just
hurricane.
Wants to hit the ground, man.
You know, this match is going to decide whether or not Street Fighter is better than Tekken, right?
Is it?
Yeah, uh-oh. No pressure, Dalton.
Oh my god. Alright, so Dalton, the one thing you're doing wrong is you're pressing a lot of kicks by itself. You want to do down, back, left, kick.
Is that the Kuma? The Kuma
that's
master?
One. That's one kick, right? That's...
He ooh, didn't that... even do it. He faked me out. I thought I was waiting for him.
That's a
I'm
true coaching right there, right?
I'm about listening to your ass.
Tell me the law. Tell me the law. Yeah.
It's like I'm listening to your ass.
He was like, what was the last time you won the tournament? I'm not listening to you. Yeah.
Hey,
he read your file.
Yeah. Hey,
do you have an interview on Tekken Gamer? I don't think so.
Do I?
No.
I do.
Do you?
I do. They interviewed me.
Oh, I
yeah,
must
I
have not read it.
Probably
was yeah, I was one of the first. No one read it, obviously. That's
oh.
They're like Bronson. Let's read about Renee Maestri.
Damn.
Is that going to work?
Oh. Yes.
The trout finish.
Gone
fishing.
Maybe it won't kill. It
didn't do that much damage.
Good to see it killed.
Obviously, it does a lot of damage.
Whoa, I didn't mean to do that. That's a little bit
set up.
The cool thing that Dalton's not showing here is that the bear has a twin fission that actually launches normally now.
Oh, look, the fish is back in the background.
Well, I don't think he knows what twin fission is.
Down forward RP LP.
Triangle square.
Down forward triangle square.
Let's see if you can do it.
Down
he's,
forward.
He's not listening to you. He's not listening to you.
He's trying to win, man.
We're trying to give you the win.
What are you talking about? We're in the final round, dude.
You got the round.
You're right.
You got the round.
Let's see how this works out for us.
It's not looking too hot now.
Oh, I missed the combo.
This is why you always pretend that you're like your stick's broken, your pad's broken.
He's dead.
Oh, he's not dead.
That's how I wanted to finish to go.
That was for science. I wanted to know.
All right. I mean, do we want to show one more? Should we show there was that Kinder stage?
Yeah, show the Kinder stage. Should we do a mirror match? Should we do a panda mirror match?
We want to do a bear match?
Let's do a
find out which is a superior species of bear.
Oh, yeah.
I've
that.
Always been a panda player, so.
Yeah, that's true, actually.
Yeah, I don't like that other one.
The other one? It's the bear.
It's too lovey-dovey for me, you know what I'm saying?
Are you Kuma or panda? Who are you going to use?
I'll use Kuma. It's cool.
Okay.
But I'm doing armored Kuma.
All right, well, I'm going to go naked panda. Can
that's
I say
the
that?
Best.
Can I say that?
That's the best one. The best one was in Tekken Tag 1, where they just had, he just had the bell and the Ling Slash.
Oh,
the best one.
The bag with stuff in it.
Oh,
it's the purse.
That's Tekken 4, bro.
Yeah, that's Tekken 4.
She was
look at all these stages.
She was ahead of her time.
Oh, see, this is definitely the
wasn't
battle.
This the stage that they had in the trailer?
Yeah,
stage?
The panda trailer, yeah.
Panda, yeah.
It's panda stage.
Do they have a special intro? We're about to find out. Because I don't.
Do they do special
Kuma
intros
has been
game?
Trying to holler at Panda forever
years.
Now. For, look, dude,
years.
He's so
confident. He's like, what's up, girl?
This guy's new gear on, too.
All right, let's see. What's he got? Force. Oh, he's rolling up to the scene.
How they both roll up.
Oh, ooh, they're in sync right now. There's still a height difference.
Kuma looks taller. Yeah.
That's because Panda's not wearing the heels. Look at that.
Oh my gosh, it launches so far now.
Wait, so down back 1-2 right after us. I don't know what her thing is.
We're going to find out. Thanks for coaching. There you go.
No.
Oh, that could have worked.
Maybe run up a hop kick?
Oh, that works too.
Hey, that is like the basics of Twin Piston combos, all right?
Yeah, in the other version where
But I mean, right, look at that. What is that? Look at the fur. It's beautiful. I'm distracted right now.
Oh.
Okay.
Let's go into let's mess around with
let's
bear stance.
Let's explore with bear stance. I'm gonna do it. Okay. Oh, that's a power crush. Okay.
There you go.
We're gonna keep doing it.
Let's do double bear stance.
Oh, you trying to pick me out.
Let's go in bear stance. Do something else.
Starts rolling.
Whoa, wait, that's new.
What'd you do?
Roll back.
That's not new.
I pressed the button. It's new.
What?
This.
No, that's down 4-3-2, man.
Yeah, but
look at the animation. It looks different. The second part is high.
It looks like it's high.
I'm all about the bear stance power crush.
Let's see this.
Oh, the double.
Oh, you're trying to do down 2-and-piston and down 4-3-2.
Yeah,
I like it.
Wonderful reach. We'll see.
Not that one.
All right, here you go. Oh, nice.
Oh, what's the rage art?
Oh, get away.
Oh, it worked.
The volleyball.
I wasn't paying attention at the loading screen. What's her rage drive?
I'm not sure.
You guys are supposed to be the pros at this game.
No.
We just got access to the Bears.
If I acted like I knew how to play, then people would think I'm a NAMM cop, and I'm not about that life.
Dude, you are as much of a NAMM cop as NAMM
cops. I'm a private detective.
By the way, guys, I've heard in the grapevine that Mr. Markman over here owned up Princess Ling.
Oh, yeah, just earlier. It was free. It was free. Like, top-placing American player?
Yeah. Supposedly one of the best players in America? Losing to...
Weren't you talking about him earlier?
Markman sucks.
It's true. You know who else is bad?
Me.
Oh, okay. I'll take that.
All right, let's hit that trout finish. Boom!
No damage. Oh, damn it.
Oh, that was beautiful. Enough this time.
That's cool. I mean, these guys have never... They don't think I play, so they go easy on me.
Who?
So I beat Peeling earlier. I mean, you should have seen what I did to Sparrow Jin. Oh, man.
Well, you've been around for a very long time, and you've never been particularly good. However, you have the experience in the juggles, and you've always had the information.
Yeah, so, like, the fish stays on the stage after
you win. That is awesome.
That is awesome.
Wait, where did the fish come from?
I used the rage art to finish.
Oh.
For you, Bronson. For you. I hope the notation's the same.
Oh, fart.
Oh.
Does she still have it? Do they still have it?
It's backpack 2-3-4, right?
Yeah.
It should be.
Oh my god, the nerfs.
Oh my, where is it?
The nerfs.
We'll find out another day.
Can I pick up that fish?
That's way too far, Mark.
Yeah, you're right. We'll try again.
It's like if you hit
looks
it
like Panda.
Pretty straight up,
the
it works, but then otherwise it
takes the win.
I mean, once you're close to being endangered, you gotta fight
you gotta
harder,
fight,
right?
Fight for your life.
That's the advantage. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed that sneak peek at some of the new stages and also at Kuma, Panda,
game.
And Eddie. Pretty game, right?
Very beautiful.
Yeah. Mm.
But I think now it's time for the show.
I think it's time for these guys.
I have questions for these guys.
The showdown. Yeah. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pepper these guys with questions while they play and see who gets on tilt more from the questions.
Not just that, you guys have an opportunity to be part of the question and
please.
Answer process.
Yeah, throw your questions into the chat if you have any questions for the pros.
Gingerine is gonna actually field some of the questions and he'll be asking. But I have my own set of questions. I want to ask Mr. 725 and Mr. Insanely here.
Why do you keep calling me that? Who is
because
that?
Because that's your name. Okay. It's not Insanely. It's Insanely Devoted.
That's true.
Is that your first Tekken name? Insanely Devoted?
No, it's actually not. It was original Samurai Trooper on Eurotekken.com.
That's right.
Boom.
Well, we're going
original
deep.
What?
We're going deep into
it was
the past year.
Ronin Warriors. The original Samurai Trooper. On Samurai or Eurotekken. I went to Eurotekken before I found Tekken Zabatsu. That's why I always talk to the European players.
Gotcha.
Yeah, so
old people talk.
If we could switch over to let Bronson, the man with the mouth over here, see if he can put his money where his mouth.
The mouth of the north.
The mouth of the north.
I remember you were talking earlier, we're not pros, all right?
Yeah,
yeah.
So
let's get that clear.
Let's get that clear. I have never entered a Tekken 7 tournament in my life.
Yep.
So I'm an amateur.
Okay.
This guy's a pro, though. He's entered tournaments.
Correct me if I'm wrong. You beat Mr. Knapps for the title of
best
in the U.S.
The moment he came back, we played for the title.
Yep.
And I messed him up.
So aren't you a pro now?
No, I just that was in a casual championship match.
A casual championship match. Got it.
So I know a lot of people in the chat are talking about reveals, but we don't have any reveals today. But recently we did announce that we will have guest characters in.
Are we going to talk about that now?
Karnov.
Yeah. So I think what we want to throw out to the chat as well to the team here is kind of what are some of the your dream characters.
I want Earthquake from Samurai Showdown.
Okay.
I want Condor from
Can you give us a reason
from
why?
Breaker's Revenge, because I like fat, ugly people.
Is that why you hang out with me? Is that why you came onto the
show? When we first started hanging out, you were skinny. Come
that's
on.
Right, that's true. So were you.
Yeah, so was I. Now we're both fat, ugly people, and we have to figure it out,
that's
right?
Cool. We found our place in life. But, I mean, Andy, what about you?
I think Link would be interesting.
Who?
Link from Breath of the Wild. Like Zelda.
Oh, okay.
Breath of the Wild.
I mean, we did see Link in some older Bandai Namco titles. We saw him in Soul Calibur 2 for the GameCube. That was a long time ago.
Yeah.
So he would like to see. Have you been playing Breath of the Wild?
No, I haven't had time.
He's just been dreaming about Link.
But I think it'd be cool.
Okay, so Bronson picked King, which is his serious character in Tekken 7.
No way.
And it looks like going up against Andy. Andy only plays Steve, by the way.
How do you play and talk and try and like have conversations?
This is the best part.
Andy, wait.
You
what? Because Andy's a real pro.
All right, we're good. I like this start.
So I have a few other questions. So Bronson, you mentioned you want to see those two characters. I mean, any other characters? I mean, like not from fighting games. Like, is it, like
not from fighting
not
games.
Not from. It doesn't have to necessarily be from a fighting game.
I don't know, dude.
You don't have like anything like you don't want to see like your
dude.
Favorite K-pop star or
oh
anything.
Can we get some like Sailor Moon? I would love to see Sailor Mars in this thing.
You think Sailor Mars is the best?
Wild, dude.
You think Sailor Mars is the best?
I think she is by far the best.
What?
I think that's a pretty common thinking, dude.
We are way off the rails here, fellas.
We are. I'm sorry. Okay, we went to anime, but anyway, so we know that obviously the game coming out June 2nd. I have to ask you, Bronson and both 725, are you guys planning on playing competitively again?
He's hella busy.
I'll try. Probably not so much. I won't be able to attend too many events.
All right.
I hate traveling.
Okay.
So. Probably not.
I mean, this is a big comparison from back in the day when you were probably one of the most traveled players.
Yeah, but I got old, you know?
We all get old.
Got a job.
I mean, I think what Tekken 7 does in a great way, it reminds a lot of these old players, and we've been seeing them. We've been seeing a lot of these old players enjoying the game again.
That is true. You're seeing a lot of people like come out of woodwork, right? Like people that hella suck at Tek 2, and they left because they sucked. Now they're back.
All right. Great analysis there, Bronson. Thank you. I'm sure we're going to see many ghosts of our past in the Tekken community coming back and just, you know, enjoying the game.
You know who I like to see? Tom Hilfig.
Tom Hilfiger came to an Anime Expo tournament to play Tekken 7.
No, nice.
He was playing. He played in the tournament.
I want to see Jop, Eric Akins.
Hopefully Jop. I mean, a lot
but
of the legends.
He complains so much that maybe I don't want to see
I mean, he's top five crybabies of all time, right?
Yeah, I completely agree. Never mind.
So, Andy, do you always play pad or?
In arcade, I play stick.
Okay.
But,
just because he's forced to. But it's so funny. Like, I mean, a lot of people might not know you're in charge of the Kwanba team.
That's
here in the U.S., but you play on pad. Let's talk about that. So, it's a lot of people know me from arcade sticks, and if I didn't use an arcade stick, they'd call me a fraud. What do you have to say about that?
Well,
I know you have an answer for this. I asked you before.
It's interesting because, like, Hanzo Hattori was known for making swords and stuff, like in Kill Bill.
He's not even looking, Andy. He's
but
like,
he's
no,
not
us.
Even like a master swordsman, like a master samurai. But you know, he still can make good swords. So it's kind of like me making joysticks.
Wow. See, that was a legit answer. And that was the best answer.
That was
I'd
the answer
heard.
That I wanted. So in case you guys didn't hear it, I'm not gonna say it again. But I just wanted to see how we would do.
You're like the Hattori Hanzo of arcade sticks.
Exactly. He is the master, the best of blacksmith.
Oh my
god, that's slow motion.
You crushed it.
That's
the beauty of it, right? Like, you know y'all play the other person with the ollie kicking stuff.
Did you say outplay someone with ollie kicks?
Back up.
So I'm obviously a big fan of King.
I can't play like
And just wrestling in general. Are you still a fan of wrestling?
Not really.
I remember you were really into it back in the day.
Was I?
Yeah.
Well, okay.
Maybe when you were like 12.
We've known each other since I was like 15, 14. So yeah. there's a long history there. Wait, I think at some point we were all into that stuff.
Yeah. Oh no.
How come you didn't do the real one? You don't
messed
know?
Up.
Do you,
are you I did it!
Oh, okay.
I said I messed up, dude. Because I'm talking to you, there's things happening.
You know, one of these things that these players are going to have to learn, a lot of these old school players, they don't know how to talk and play at the same time.
Why do you need to talk? You're just beating some dude.
See, the secret is, and I'll tell you earlier, and you guys probably saw it when I was playing, is you don't play good when you talk. You don't do real combos when you talk.
Yeah, it's a difficult skill.
You get hit by everything.
Oh my god.
You got those?
Wow, that was pretty good combo.
Oh, I haven't even been watching. I didn't know you could do the 4-4-1 combo.
It's actually not that hard. I don't know.
It's just a matter of doing it at the time. I mean, but
in tournament, I've already talked to Jimmy about this. We're not gonna go for it. Okay. We're not gonna do it.
I don't think anyone goes for it. So
you probably you don't need to.
Yeah, it's like 4 points of damage, right?
But why you do it is for wall carrying.
For sure.
That's why you do it. Otherwise, you don't really need it.
So Andy takes the win with Steve.
Yeah, it happens.
Bronson's used to it.
Bronson's used to
it. There's this thing though. During Tekken 4 Nationals.
Well, okay, so you're bringing up a 20-year-old story.
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
He cleared the road for me.
Yes, he made an amazing tear through the loser's bracket.
Right, he just beat up everybody for me, and then that was the time when I could actually beat him every time, and he gave me a free ride to Grand Finals, and I appreciate that. So when I lose to him here,
But I mean, you only won Grand Finals because the player didn't know how to fight your character. And that was a miraculous pick.
Whatever.
I remember it too.
These are details that no one cares about.
You went through the bracket beating everyone with Paul and Jin.
Yeah, and then Arario just beat me down.
Yeah, and then you got destroyed. And then someone said, hey, you should try your scrubby character.
Yeah, Tom was like, hey, just pick Julia. No one in Atlanta knows how to pick Julia. And I was like, all right, I'll play Julia. Never played her in my life in Tekken 4.
And I believe you came back 7 straight matches.
Yeah, it was like 8-0, 8-1. He played late. He picked late.
That's how shook he was.
In that game?
Yeah, and it's okay that we talk Crash Battle because he fell off the face of the earth.
Yeah, where is he now?
I don't
know. He's busy to beat you in Tekken 7.
Where's your Claudio?
I don't.
He only
secret.
Picks Claudio because he thinks he looks like him.
And that's why his. Have you seen his Twitter
People
avatar?
People like Gigas. Yeah, have you seen my Twitter avatar?
Yeah, it's Claudio Psyduck.
Yeah,
beautiful, dude.
I mean, you don't want to see Psyduck in Tekken?
No.
I mean, we've had Gon.
Yeah, we've had Gon before, and that fool was broken, dude.
All right.
Same with Yoda, too.
Yeah, I don't want broken characters.
Yoda from Soul Calibur?
Yeah.
So you're admitting Tekken is a pretty balanced game. Hey, the cops are here. You be careful. Dalton has a gun.
They're looking at me right now, man.
It's pretty good. I mean, anyone that's trying to get into Tekken now, I'd have to say it's actually a really refreshing experience compared to most fighting games that are out there now. It's easier to get into. Legacy skill obviously will help go a long way, but teaching people has never been easier for me.
Yeah.
It's been really fun.
And also the reversals, too. You know, the ability to come back.
Yeah. The
the comeback mechanics definitely factor. Help out people.
Yeah. And, I mean,
and as we mentioned earlier, that adds a lot to viewership and just the ability to understand what's going on in the game. You know, a lot of fighting games have people have difficulty kind of following understanding what's going on.
Yeah.
Tekken's a really kinetic game. It's got
it's
very manageable to watch from a
good
viewer
job.
Perspective.
Well played.
And just looking at things like Rage Art's not like super powerful. It obviously it's a great comeback mechanic if you hit it, but if it gets blocked you're done. You're toast.
Yeah.
For the most part.
Yeah, you're punished. You're screwed.
It's a good
few
balance.
That are safe though, right?
There's one that's safe. Huarong's is safe just because he has
there
to pull it
safe
up from
stuff. High ones.
Steve. Well, it's
Steve. Jin.
But they're high.
Obviously. They're high. Yeah.
And in this game, it's pretty easy to see the.
And Huarong's you have to do from out. Stance too.
That's why. It's good. Back up.
He gas is doing work right now. I see tentacles all over the place.
Oh my god. Why a Gigas choice there?
People like Gigas.
They call this an option select. So when you
dude,
lose,
I'm playing low tier.
Yeah,
right?
When you lose, you have an excuse.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
You put a little buffer. Put a little buffer in there. Oh yeah, it's gonna make those Gigas.
It's a skill I've learned from one of the best players in the world, Tom Hilfer.
Yeah, the term is probably a newer school term, option select, but it's an old school strat.
Oh no.
It basically, the an excuse.
Nah, dude, it's real. I'm playing a horrible character.
No, there are no bad. We went over this, Bronson. Oh. There are no bad characters.
All right,
just bad players.
No, that dude.
I thought good players adapt.
Oh.
One game.
Shots fired.
Yeah, that's what I've been saying for a very long time. So what other questions you guys have for us?
Yeah, let's actually check what chat and what Twitter may have. We'll see what's going on.
You know, a lot of people are interested in the new stages. You know, we showed some of the new stages earlier.
Yep.
So, you know, we'll have the VOD up over later so you guys can check them out.
Yeah.
But, you know,
analyze it. I want to see the internet go crazy and analyze everything they saw on the stream earlier.
Oh, we shot Infinite Azure. We showed the Kinder Gym.
Arena.
The new arena. Yeah, yeah. So there's some awesome new stages. And we're, you know, I think fans are really going to enjoy the variety of stages too. There's a lot out there. There's a lot of different styles too. You know, there's stages without walls. There's stages that have different levels. Changes up the battle a little bit.
There's a church stage too.
The Duomo.
Cathedral of Sirio or whatever.
There are a lot of characters in this game.
What was that?
There are a lot of characters
and stages.
Yeah. I mean, not as much as Tag 2, though.
That's true. But it might get there someday.
Not as much as Tag 2, though.
How many did Tag 2 have? 60?
No.
Too many.
I think it was 40 something. 40 something. The higher end of 40?
Really? And then this has what, like 40?
Over 4? No, there's like
30 plus.
30 something.
Yeah.
Interesting. But who knows? I mean, obviously, there's still guest characters out there.
So Ice Cold Edge, he's asking Bronson, where are those strong style vids?
How do you know about these questions?
Hey, buddy.
Oh, man.
Exit right.
Next question.
I actually have all of them.
They're all on YouTube.
I know. I really have all videos from that tournament, which is amazing. We were able to capture everything. It's just that...
It was just like a year late.
Dude, our promise was a big ask from our little team, so we didn't get to do it. However, we do have everything.
So if you guys want to watch old stuff,
there's
a market for that, right? You definitely have an opportunity. Look up Strong Style. Was it 4 or 5? It was an old Strong Style, but it was for Tag 2. It was fun stuff. So okay, so your Claudio makes an appearance.
No. People have to realize I can't beat Andy. I can't.
Use the new character stuff?
Oh, there we go. There we go.
I can cheat him.
Oh, no. Oh, it. Oh, you.
I respect it.
You could have blocked that, by the way. That
That was only on counter. Starburst, huh?
Get my blue up, you know?
Oh, he hits you with the Shoryu?
Oh.
Bad combo.
Yeah. There are no bad combos. Never mind.
Dude, there are bad combos.
Yeah.
And Andy has done them for about 20 years.
So. I could do the good ones sometimes.
That's true. That's the beauty of this game. When you have players like Andy being
able to...
All right, never mind. All right, I got my blue. You ready for this mix-up?
I'm ready.
This is the real mix-up right here. You keep the blue, right?
I know a lot of people are asking about the release date. You know, we're really close to launch here, guys. We're less than 2 months away. We're pretty close to 2 months away. Yeah. But June 2nd is the launch.
Super up forward one.
So you don't have to wait too much longer. We're also going to have, you know, more tournament coverage, more Tekken talks. Oh, we didn't talk about the dev blog.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm glad you brought that up. So I guess we could announce this to everyone that's tuning in, but... over on Tekken.com, we're finally going to have a developer's blog where we're going to talk about the developments of the game and everything that's going on in the community. So I urge all of you guys to check that out. It'll be launching pretty soon before the game comes out. But we'll have a lot more information and we'll have a lot more detailings on a lot of the cool stuff that you can find in the game when we're able to announce it. So I'm pretty excited about that.
And I know we're going to be working with you too to do some more tutorials and kind of get everyone ready for Tekken 7.
You guys are doing tutorials and stuff?
No.
Oh, okay.
Don't say you guys, but there will be tutorials. Yeah.
I heard Mr. Dalton here say
we're working on them as a team. We're going to make sure that people are ready for the game because, you know, there are a lot of newcomers to Tekken, and there's a lot of mechanics that you guys take for granted that you think are commonplace, but new players don't understand that.
There's a lot of stuff here. I mean, you know, usually when you see competitive play, you probably see just the best of the combos, the best of the moves that people are using. There's a lot of things out there that you might not know about, and hopefully we'll be able to show that and showcase it to a lot of the players here. I see Bronson getting so frustrated
it's
over
not
there.
Not working this combo.
But anyways, if you guys, of course, interested, June 2nd, PS4, Xbox One, and Steam platforms. Not only that, there is a season pass as well, and we talked about that season pass, including some extra stages, and of course, two guest characters, which I'm really excited
about. And there's some surprises in the DLC that's coming that will be...
What?
The guest characters? Like, they are not... Yako knows who they are.
I don't know what you're talking about, dude.
Yeah.
There's guest
that's a normal question.
We're looking into it.
We are like 4 months, 2 months.
Hey, man,
have
you ever had to answer a question with a cop pointing a gun at you? That's how I feel right now.
I see some power poses over on the side.
Yeah, be careful. See that? That's not a camera.
I think the fans are going to be really excited about the guest characters.
Yeah, you know, I'll say, I mean, if you guys were impressed with what that Faded Retribution brought and the appearance of Akuma, it's going to be just as hype, if not better. Yeah. I was super excited when that happened, and I can only urge you guys to be excited for
what's coming up. Yeah, and, you know, there's things like, you know, costumes. There's a lot of great stuff.
Costumes, customizations.
A lot of stuff that's on the way that I think a lot of fans are going to be really excited about.
Oh, especially the man. There are a lot of fans out there, and they've been asking the same questions over and over again. They'll have their answers soon enough. There's a lot of cool stuff that's going to be announced.
Just soon. About 2 months, guys. So hang in there. Stay up with the tournament coverage, and you know we're going to have a lot more information about the post-launch tournament scene, the DLC plans, the new characters. So just stay tuned. You know, stay up on the Tekken channels from Facebook, Twitter, Twitch. We'll make sure that you guys are informed and ready for the June 2nd launch.
Yeah. So again, thanks everyone for tuning in. This is gonna be the last match of the day.
Yeah, let's see.
Wow. I'm gonna go turn on commentary mode, and I'm gonna talk as much smack as I can with these guys next.
No.
So we have Insanely Devoted, the guy that really gave the nickname to Jody the Great. Here we go. Nice pressure here from 725.
There's no pressure going on.
725, one of the original Steve players. Been playing Steve since Tekken 4. Nice hop kick there from Bronson. Has to modify his combo. Goes for the running too. What a duck there.
No, he's just ducking every time, dude.
I mean, it's a valid strat. Okay. Caught him out of the air. Sniped him. Tied up on rounds right now. One round apiece. Gets him with a gut punch and the follow-up.
Combo.
Eight, man, that's decent damage, I think. I mean, Steve didn't get that before from a counter down 4-2. Here we go.
One thing I want to mention, too, is everyone that signed up for the giveaway, we'll be picking the winners and reaching out to you guys a little later. So we had the Kwamba, Obsidian Light Stick, as well as Crying Hihachi hats to give away to the fans. You know, thanks so much, you guys, for tuning in. Really appreciate the support for Tekken. As I said, stay tuned to the social channels as well as Markman's channel for all information that's kind of coming up. The tournament scene, as well as new information about the game. So we're gonna close out this round. We're gonna see if Bronson can put his money where his mouth is.
That is not the way you
fight back. Come on, Andy. Let's take it to a final round.
Oh no! Too much pressure.
What, loser pays for dinner?
Oh, oh wow.
Is that what happened?
The stakes are up.
What, steak dinner?
Oh, no.
Oh, man, he's turning it up right now.
The steak's for steak.
Oh, no. Hey, what are you doing?
Let's drop it.
Throw that arrow, Claudio.
No.
Throw that arrow. No.
Snipers.
All right.
Before we head out, I know, Bronson, we're going to see you pretty soon again at NCR. You'll probably be there, too, right?
Actually, I won't be traveling.
Oh, you'll be traveling. Okay. Oh, yeah, we've talked about that.
Traveling the world every day.
Anything you want to say to everyone that's tuned in and watching? And again, thank you for helping us with the giveaway.
Yeah, thanks so much for the Kwamba steak.
So
really,
anything you guys want to say? This is your forum. If you say anything bad, the guns are pointing, just so you know.
I've seen this Namco brand manager walking back and forth throughout this whole show, waiting for me to get off the stage. So I'm not gonna say anything because he might hit me after I come out. So go ahead, Andy.
Valid.
Hey, good job, Kwamba. Go ahead.
Just looking forward to June 2nd.
Did you say January? I was like, no. Did he delete it?
2018? No,
I'm just joking.
June 2nd, guys. June 2nd.
Is about 65 days away, so we're just about there, guys. So yeah, not too much longer to wait. So thank you guys so much for coming. Really appreciate you guys coming by and talking about the game. You know, showing us some of your skills. I mean, Bronson could get a little bit better, but you know, we're like.
Listen here, Mr. Dalton. For someone that doesn't know anything about this game, you have no right to say anything.
I'll see you guys.
We haven't played yet.
I've seen you play.
I'll see you guys at Northwest Majors and at NCR. So again, thanks guys for tuning in for this edition of Tekken Talk. We will have another one next month. We're gonna show you guys some juicy stuff, so I hope you guys look forward to that. But until then, we'll see you. Thank you.
Thank you guys so much. See ya.